Hi, I'm Rose Hayden with Hunt Regional Healthcare, and I'm with Bindhu Oommen, MD, with Hunt Regional Medical Partners. Thank you for being here today.
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. And Dr. Oommen actually received her BA from Austin College and her medical degree from Texas Tech. She completed her general surgery residency at the University of Tennessee Medical Center and completed her fellowship in minimally invasive and complex hernia care at Charlotte, North Carolina. We are so glad to have her back in Texas. Dr. Oommen's been with us about 3 years.
Yes, that's correct.
So let's start. First of all, what is a hernia?
So a hernia is a condition in which an organ or tissue protrudes through a defect or a weakness. For example, intestine can protrude through a hernia in the abdominal wall, or stomach or other organs can protrude from the abdomen through the diaphragm into the chest, and those are usually called hiatal hernias.
Wow, okay, and so what are the symptoms? What does the patient experience?
So symptoms can vary based on the location and other patient factors, but most often if it's in the abdominal wall, it may present first as a bulge or even a pain with or without a bulge.
Wow.
There may also be other symptoms, for example, if intestines get strangulated or incarcerated in an abdominal wall defect, they may present with obstruction or nausea, vomiting, things like that.
Wow.
In the stomach or in the diaphragm defects, there may be symptoms of reflux because the stomach is now pushed through the chest into the chest cavity, or they may have feeling of difficulty swallowing or difficulty or early satiety, a feeling of fullness in their stomach.
Okay, so sometimes you're seeing something externally, sometimes it's your symptoms.
Correct.
Right? Exactly. So, and then maybe you're just not feeling well, or like you said, you might have some eating issues or
correct.
Pain.
Okay. Correct.
And so is it important to treat the hernia early, or is this something you can wait to treat?
Sure. I would say in general, most hernias, because they're defects, would be better treated when they're smaller. As to whether they need to be treated and when, that's really a discussion you need to have with your surgeon. And the reason for that is because there are many factors that get need to be considered when you repair a hernia. One is not just patient factors, but it's the hernia factors, the location, the size, things like that. And also, what are the outcomes from the surgery itself? And a lot of those need to be considered together to know when and if they need to be treated.
And what are the treatment options?
So treatment options are so variable based on where the hernia is and the symptoms that you're having. In general, for example, an abdominal wall hernia, I would say the considerations for whether they present electively in the office or whether it's an emergent surgery would be a very important consideration. And then in terms of options for treatment, you know, are we going to use an open approach or a laparoscopic approach? Mm. Are we going to do, is this a recurrent hernia? Is this an issue where we have to use mesh, or should we not use mesh? Okay. And if so, what kind of mesh? So there's many options available, even considering the hiatal hernias in the chest. There's, you know, patient factors that we have to consider. And another important consideration as to what options we have is, you know, with abdominal wall hernias, you know, diabetes, smoking, obesity, all of these really affect the outcome and therefore what approach you take. And so it's very important to have that discussion openly with your surgeon so that you can figure out what's best for you and what your expectations are for the hernia repair.
Okay, very good. And so would someone need to be referred by a doctor to come see you as a surgeon, or could they come to you directly?
I would say that the majority of our referrals come from other physicians or even family members who've seen the surgeons before. But there are many people who come through the ER, mm-hmm. and some that are even self-referred. They look up someone in the area and then try to get seen.
Okay, so they could call your office.
Correct.
And make an appointment themselves. Okay,
correct.
Very good. And so can hernias be prevented?
So when I think about prevention, so Hernias can be congenital, or the person is born with it, and then as they grow older, they may become larger. There's also acquired hernias that come from trauma, prior surgical incisions. And so it's important, I mean, obviously if you're born, you can't prevent it. But in terms of acquired hernias, things that can prevent them from becoming symptomatic or enlarging are things like maintaining an ideal body weight, avoiding excessive or heavy lifting in an inappropriate way. For example, not using all of your abdominal muscles to lift heavy things.
Do you see that often? Does that happen?
A lot of times, you know, people will come in with groin hernias and they're like, I remember lifting this, you know, and they'll notice a bulge or pain. Additionally, avoiding conditions that may cause increased abdominal pressure, such as constipation, chronic coughing, sneezing.
Okay.
Also, if you've had trauma or surgical incisions, smoking is a big risk factor for increased risk for hernias, because smoking does inhibit and affect wound healing, and so you can get hernias like that.
Good tip. Very good. So sometimes people do need to actually do the surgery, it sounds like. And how often or how long would they be off work?
I would say it really depends on the nature of their work.
Sure.
And also the nature of their hernia repair.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, if your occupation requires a lot of heavy lifting, I tell all my patients no heavy lifting for 6 weeks.
Okay.
If they're able to do light duty, then that's
sure. You
know, something that I can help provide, you know, documentation for.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
But better to go ahead and get it done now then have it get worse, it sounds
correct.
Like.
Yes.
Absolutely. That's wonderful.
Yes.
Well, thank you so much for your time
no
today.
Problem.
That's been very informative. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
This video has been brought to you by GEUS 34. GEUS is your community-owned provider of electric, internet, cable TV, and true local programming.